today we could do a renovation update, so I'm going to sneeze. It's been a while and we are still renovating. As I've mentioned before, the renovations on this property, they're years long. It goes on and on and on and on. It's a very old property, it's over 100 years old. It needs TLC, it needs big jobs done to it, it needs small jobs done to it. It just needs TLC, like starting the baby steps from the beginning, basically, and like trying to do it in a way that makes sense so that we're not redoing things a million times, we're not like going back on ourselves. So yeah, Mark is like the king of planning and organization and everything to do with that. But I'm the queen of making it look pretty, which if I'm looking around the kitchen, and don't get me wrong, our kitchen is very pretty and I love it, but I made a point for this video, I haven't tidied anything up, I just walked into the kitchen, got out my camera, and you can see what it like genuinely looks like right now. We're gonna do a bit of a chat kind of about the kitchen, some issues that we're having, what renovations we're currently having going on. I've mentioned they're outside, we can take a little look at that. I thought I would quickly share with you the downstairs bathroom. I think I showed that to you in video, but I'm not sure I've shown it to you finished. Honestly, so happy with that. Like, that is all good, we love that. And then I thought we could go out into the garden and just have a little look around, show you the greenhouse, gardener Mark can have a talk with you. Yeah, just general like house update stuff. So, the kitchen. As I mentioned in the previous video, we came back from our Easter breakaway to like leaks, like lots and lots and lots of leaks. More leaks than ever before. I feel like I could go around and show you at least like maybe 8 places that it is leaked or is leaking or is currently leaking, has leaked in the past. There's some definite, not only like repairs that have to happen, but like touching up that also has to happen after that. We currently don't have our lights in the light fitting. You'll see that when I show you around. Because Mark like looked and he was like, oh my word, there's water in that. The actual like bottom of the light fitting had just filled with water, like a solid couple of inches of water. So that's obviously terrifying. It's mixed with electricity. Oh my word. Some things are needing to happen. Yeah, rightly so, people like your kitchen has been leaking for a very long time. Yes, it has. It's so tricky. It's really hard to know what to say online. I don't want to get anyone in trouble. But at the same time, we're obviously not very, we're not happy about this. And fingers crossed, we think we're like finding a route out of it. We found someone that can help us. Eventually we'd love to have a green roof on top of the flat roof of the kitchen. And in a way, it's really good that we didn't have it done. We just didn't have the budget to stretch to that like right now whilst we were doing it. And it's a really good thing that we didn't, because obviously we would have put the green roof in and then had all these problems with the roof and would have had to have like taken the green roof off and kind of started again from scratch. So it's kind of good that that hasn't happened. And our plan is to find somebody who specializes in this, who really knows what they're doing. Mark has some hopeful leads in that direction, and we can kind of sort out the leaks once and for all, do a solid year, like have a rainy winter, spring, and just see what happens. Fingers crossed no leaks, and then we can start on the green roof, because that'll be really exciting and the pièce de résistance of this whole kitchen renovation. And then hopefully, once the leaks are sorted, we can like finish it off. Like, I want to put some art in here. I mean, we've made a start with these shelves, but now I've started, I kind of don't want to stop. I'm like, oh, I think there's some more that we want to do over here. I think there's like a table that we want to get for the corner. We want to kind of dress up the side tables a little bit. So yeah, let me take you around and kind of show you where we're at. I'm actually not sure we've shown you the door, but our carpenter Caleb, who did all the wooden like fluted panels in here, took our original door and has like refurbished it. We've got new hardware on it. He put in this new reeded glass, which is just so beautiful. So super happy with that. And it matches the reeded glass of the utility as well. I'm not gonna show you in there because that's always a little bit of a mess, but it's a utility, so it should be. We've also got this massive piece of wood here right now, which is for the Align event that we're having really soon in the house. We needed to make the table a little bit bigger, so we've just got like a massive piece of wood and we're gonna put it on top of our table, and it just means that everybody can sit around that. But once this is out of the way, leaks are sorted, we think we're gonna do like a big piece of art on the wall here. Definitely need a plant. I think maybe like some kind of lighting fixture here. I think we're gonna go to Arden Light Antiques there and maybe see if there's like a sideboard. Yeah, we know that there's some dressing of this area that kind of needs to happen. But yeah, this is the rest of the kitchen as
you walk in. Oh, look, it's all very smooth. Oh, there's not too much washing up, so love to see it. That's good. I mean, I'm so happy that we didn't have a hob or like anything like that on the counter, because this counter is just like the main workspace of the kitchen. Oh, sorry, massive piece of dust. Stick that in the bin. This is Ralph's little like standy tower thing, and he stands here and he's got all these like his little sink that he plays with and stuff. He's always just kind of pottering around here having his food or whatever. And then down here we've got Plant City going on. My mum got me some flowers. Thank you, mum. Our friends bought us this plant. Thank you, Matt and Sally. And then we're trying to grow, I think my auntie got me this, and it's a butterfly mix. Planted it on Sunday. It's now Thursday, and we've got some little shoots. They're coming up. That's really excited. So that's just going to be a pot that's going to go out in the garden. And then my mum and dad for Easter got Ralph a grow your own strawberry set. We planted that out at the weekend as well, but haven't had any success so far with that. It's still early days. I'm becoming a seed influencer, I've decided. I picked these up. I can't remember what the website was, but I'll link them down below for you. But they are an Icelandic poppy pastel mix. So this weekend we'll have to go and plant those out. I've just made a pile here. I opened the package a couple of days ago. That is just now where they're living. And then this is the Matilda Goad big shell that we fill with like lemons, limes, whatever we've got going on. We'll have a little talk about the garden in a moment, but it's looking a little bit darker in here because this is our skylight and it's currently boarded up because of the rendering stuff that we're doing outside. So it's kind of interesting to see what this room was like without a skylight. It's still obviously like the window's massive, it's really nice and bright, but it is so much nicer with the skylight in. So that was definitely a good call. Well done, architects. Over here is like leak number one. Like this is the really bad one. Up in the corner there, that is the main culprit. So yeah, this is what this area is currently looking like, which is a shame because our pillows are currently sitting here. Obviously we would love those in the corner. I think the idea for this corner, let's just like have a little chat, is to do, obviously the pillows will go back. So the pillows are in the L shape in a corner. And then I think over here we'll have a kind of floor lamp, I think, and maybe a book, like something decorative on that corner, because that corner kind of sticks out beyond the pillow. So that's a bit, works as a bit of a side table. Then I think we're going to have an actual table here in the corner. There's one from Hay that's this gorgeous rust red color. And I think we will pop that there. Or another option, we've considered having a lower chair like here and just making that like a seating corner. But if you're sat down on a chair, it's going to be quite low and people are going to be sat quite high up there. So I think it's nicer to have that as a little kind of breakfast nook area. Then this space becomes completely free and we can put, yeah, like dress this up as a bit of a coffee table. And then Caleb, our carpenter, changed all of these drawers. These were on like a push, like you kind of push them in and it pulled them out. But it meant that when people sat in front of them, their calves hit it and it kind of kept coming out. So we've changed it. So it's just a little ridge underneath, and these just have, oh my gosh, they're so handy. These have all of our like summer beach bits and bobs in. Super, super, super handy. Every single one of those is full. So that's kind of the plan for this corner. I think you've seen the concrete kitchen area outside. It's just so nice that all the plants are kind of starting to have their moment out there. And you've seen this, you've definitely seen this corner. Picked up these chairs from Interior, really, really like those. It's so funny, when we put the big board on the table, it just made us think like, oh, could we do with a bigger table? But this table fits us and our life and like what we need it for perfectly. So it's just the end of the table is always like pile central. Like, you know, you have to have your pile somewhere, right? I'm sure I've shown you this before, but just in case I haven't shown you it like finished, like this is now all in. We've got some drawers to the other side that have like our shoes in it, but this is our top secret hidden downstairs bathroom. Oh my gosh, never had a downstairs bathroom before. But this is, it's so nice. Why did I not have this when I was pregnant? It would have been so handy. Just super, super happy with it. So on this side, we've got that. On this side is where the toilet is. Do a little pan down. Yeah, we're super, super, super happy with this. Love that we went for a bit of a crazy tile, a bit of a crazy color scheme compared to everywhere else. It's just a fun, a fun little colourful nook.
I hadn't actually been out to see this yet, but yeah.
This is the outside currently. So this is just a re-rendering situation of like this side of the house, this side of the house, and then also the back, like around there as well. There was just so many cracks. It needed it. We kind of knew that the house needed re-rendering when we bought it. And we thought we'd do these two bits first, and then we'll do eventually the other side and the front of it. But yeah, a lot of scaffolding. This is currently the situation. And now I will not be going to the top because that sounds really scary.
You're good?
Look at you, ring your alarm. Okay, what's he called? Monty Don.
Monty Don.
Yeah, got your like gardening shoes on and everything. Yeah. I thought I'd just do like a bit of a general what tour, and then maybe we could go in the greenhouse.
Yeah.
Let's have a little chat.
Cool.
So not ordered yet, but coming soon, garden furniture. We've obviously got our hay table and chairs that we got last summer, the summer before. But we really want like comfortable seating. The question is, what do we do? It's sunnier on the end, so I'm thinking we do like comfortable seating on that end and then dining table here, or do we do dining table where it is and comfortable seating this end? I don't know. Let me know your thoughts. Got the little pizza oven situation going on up there, and the what are these called, the pleached trees are looking incredible. They're crab apples, and they're just gonna, yeah, they've already like blossoming, and it's gonna provide some really nice like privacy to the garden and just like extra greenery. The bees love them, the birds love them, super happy with those. So yeah, if you walk down, oh by the way, we're gonna pressure wash this, and I'm so excited to do it. Like, that's one of those tasks that I just love to do. There you go, that's Mark in his happy place right there. Let's have a little wander around this side first. People, in fact, I'm always asked about this. Is this a cold plunge? No, it's a pond. But it does look a bit like a cold plunge. It's just so nice. I swear we went away for 3 nights and all of the trees and the plants are just like, they're growing. It's great. Super in love with this tree. The blossom is going already though. How wild is that? But eventually that'll be a tree. It just looks so nice from the kitchen. And also I think we've got, I'm not sure what these are, but these bright green ones at the back, I think there's three of them, and there's this trailing trellis all along the bungaroosh wall. I think this wall is called bungaroosh. I just always think it's such a fun name. And eventually the plants will just go along there, which would be super nice. Grass is looking good. Mark's not super happy with the grass, but it's looking good. Wisteria at the back, it's just coming out. The pond is looking good. The birds love the pond. They all come, they have a little bath, they have a little drink, which is just so lovely. Yeah, the wisteria is coming out. It's almost ready to have its little moment. Oh, something's having a good old dig back there. So this is what we built at the weekend. As you can imagine, I'm quite tall and Mark's quite tall, and our boy is tall. So he already feels this. He's probably like 2 centimeters away from needing to bend down when he goes in, bless him. But here's what we're thinking of making, like a little area for him here. Obviously pond is here, so we're going to do like some big pots down this side just to create a bit of a barrier. So maybe like a herb garden for him, just some pots where he can like, I don't know, play with them and like make a little mud kitchen. There's a little mud kitchen on the side of this. And then maybe a little table and chairs for him. And also we need to paint this. Thoughts on colours? I'm thinking like the colour of that tree. Do you know what I mean? Like a really deep green. I think that could look really nice, just so it like blends in with the garden quite nicely, especially when the wisteria comes out. But yeah, I'd love to hear your thoughts on that, or if there's any like brand of, I don't know, kids paint or like kids safe paint that you used, let me know, because yeah, I think that's what we're going to pop there. Oh, the sun's coming out, that's nice. The little mud kitchen on the side, so much fun. We haven't popped anything in this back corner yet, but I think Mark's going to do maybe some raspberry bushes or something, some fruit bushes in this corner. And then these are Mark's two areas where we're going to have the bulk of our fruit and veg planting. So these two trees are apple trees, and one of them is called Newton Wonder. I can tell why Mark picked that. Our second name is Newton, I love that. And then another apple tree. But they look a bit sad. If you look closer up, there you go. There's something going on there. I really love the kind of random planting that the gardeners put here and like the garden designer put here. This is actually like all supposed to be here. And we're going to have a little table and chairs under here because this to me is like just such a gorgeous view. Like, oh my gosh, I just love it so much. Also, Ralph's favourite place here. They always love like the tiny little place that they can sneak into. Here is the bed that I prepared the other day. Oh, what are you putting there?
That's a fox, I think.
Oh, a fox. This was the area that I prepared the other day. I can't remember what we planted, but we planted something. Yeah, but I thought the billy buttons were in there. Mark's just reminded me that it was sweet peas. We've done some sweet peas down here. We've done some rose, but the rest of this is probably going to be like my Icelandic poppies that are inside. And I've got some other things I need to plant out. But yeah, I love this little area and I can't wait to get just a little cafe. You know what I mean? Like a little tiny, two chairs and a little table. That's going to be so nice there. And then yeah, this is Mark's favourite place.
Flipping out in here though.
Is it? Are you sweating? Just think Mark picked a really nice greenhouse. He's having his Diet Coke moment, bless him. Let's have a little look inside. So when the landscapers were here, they built us a path, which is so nice. And then we can just plant on this side and plant on this side as well. We have an olive tree that we've had for about 3.5 years now, and it just looks really sad. But we're trying to bring it back to life. If anyone has any tips or advice, we're definitely all ears for that. Oh my gosh, it's so warm in here, babes.
I know.
Jeez. And then here's what we planted out at the weekend. Has anything popped through yet? Oh, yeah. Can you see?
Oh yeah.
This one.
And there. All at the back as well.
There. Oh yeah, look at those. So that's gypsophilia at the back. And then these ones are billy buttons. So eventually they'll go into my cut flower bed. Oh, nice. Yeah, they'll go in my cut flower bed, which is this one. It was just really fun and really relaxing. Let's go sit up here and have a chat. Probably shouldn't be sat in bright white jeans on our kind of dirty garden chairs, but still. Yeah, stubbing out those seeds was so relaxing and just one of those moments when you're like, I feel like I've literally dreamed about this life. Like me, Mark and Ralph pottering about in a garden, just having a grand old time. It was so, so nice. The landscapers did it like last summer, but it was more like last September, October time that they actually planted it out. So we haven't had a spring or summer with a proper garden like this. It's like the garden of our dreams. So it just feels, honestly, this is my happy place. Like this is where I want to spend all my time. This is 34, like doing seed hauls. Love it. Love this. Quiet, chill, like it's so nice. I feel very, very, very lucky. Anyway, this is the end of the renovation / garden update. Hopefully you enjoyed this. I know so many of you want Mark to do a gardening Instagram account. I'm trying, guys. I'm trying. He's just there, he's got his fork, he's having a great old time. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. Let me know what you'd like to see next, and I will see you with a brand new video very soon. Thank you. Bye.